today.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. How are you? Good to see you.
See you later.
One more picture. Let me take one picture. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
What's up?
What's up, Shane? How are you?
BTO!
Sorry, guys. What's up?
Hey, how are you?
So, got a couple Eastern Bloc cars here, basically as found barn finds from the 90s.
From where?
I don't know exactly where, but you know, when the wall came down and everybody went in and started pulling them out, these were pulled out very early
on.
The Bumblebee, as we call it here, is a Yahtzee confirmed. It's early 43.
43, okay.
Of course, many modifications, but...
Type 60 or type 82?
The problem is neither car has the ID badges. This one's standing on a Kugel wagon chassis at present. So it would have had 82E suspension. Many modifications, but enough of the original details that Yahtzee was able to determine March, April, 43 production. Still has
the crash transmission.
Some interesting modifications. Took the bus reduction boxes and cut them off and made straight axles because they had to use whatever they had to keep the cars going.
Yeah. Look at those fenders, how they modify it.
You know. And then incredible dashboard with, you know, different gauging, but the dash has not been butchered up. Kugel wagon seats.
Kugel wagons?
Original cab doors, KDF doors. So even though there were many modifications, they retained a lot of the original pieces.
Well, interesting, those steering wheels.
Yeah, it's nothing VW about it. Nothing VW. Yet you look at the pedals, it still has the small roller.
Yeah, wow.
So it's interesting that even though they modified, they kept all the parts and reused whatever they had to use to keep the car going.
So they just fix whatever they can and then keep running.
It's got the custom modified extended hood. But they did a nice job.
Yeah, they did a nice job, yeah.
And
yeah,
it
very
has,
interesting.
Let's see if I can get open it. It's a little tricky.
Oh wow!
So even though the KDF tank is gone, it still has
yes.
the cutouts
yeah, cutout is a,
where
like
the
KDF,
beer keg
yeah.
would have sat.
Wow!
But some
interesting
original features that Jacek noticed these. Just these two little braces here on either side tells the story that it's early 43 because by mid 43 they'd eliminated.
Okay, those. Wow.
So quite primitive.
Yeah, very interesting. This is. Okay, Charlie, tell me about the other one.
The other car is, I don't know exact month, but 45. And in many ways, this car is rarer than that car. It's after KDF, but before Volkswagen.
Yeah.
So it's in that small time period where it was Wolfsburg Motor Works, and they were just starting to get the production geared back up after the war.
So this one is before the British Army took over the car.
That's Jacek knows maybe a little more, but Jacek told me. He doesn't even know much about this car because there are very few 45 examples to inspect.
Yeah, yeah.
He knows 10 times more about this than this. So actually turns out this is probably the rarer car.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's not as modified as the Bumblebee. Still has original twist hood.
Wow.
First year with the small tank. KDF tank is gone. Some details here.
Oh wow.
There's the 46 has an additional reinforcement here.
Yeah.
So even without the numbers, they were able to do detective work and determine what it is.
Wow, this is very interesting.
Unfortunately, they cut the split out, but you know, that's something that we can do.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it was still rear engine.
Still rear engine. Wow.
Later transaxle, but nothing really modified. Mm-hmm. Still embossed deck lid. We can't find numbers on it, but possibly original deck lid.
Yeah, wow. So this is also came from the Eastern Europe?
Eastern Bloc. As I said, when the wall came down and everybody started going pulling these cars out, they were left behind. But you know, in Eastern Germany and Poland and Czech, you got a car and it had to last your whole life. You didn't get another car.
Yeah,
and that's why these survived. If these cars were in the West, they would have long been rusted out and crushed.
Yeah.
So this one has been hacked up a little inside, but the other giveaway is up until 45, it had a double panel, and then they went to the solid panel in 46.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And we can see that this was originally a double panel dash.
Your steering wheel is original?
No, it's out of an Opel. Or,
okay.
But, you know, again, they just got whatever they could. So this chassis, you'll notice in here, it just has this single heater cable.
Oh, yeah.
And they were like that until 48. So even though we were under the impression it's a Kubel chassis, it's a possible early Beetle chassis that they welded the Kubel numbers in.
Wow.
Because the Kubel had no heater.
Mm-hmm.
So what year is this?
45. So original passenger door, later Zwitter.
That's a later Zwitter door.
But if you look at the passenger door, it has the knuckle hinges, which were only 45. 6-7. See these hinges?
Oh, yeah.
Totally different.
Yeah.
So this is original door. The hood and the deck lid, we have to do a little more.
Yeah.
But again, other than the split and the dashboard, this car is pretty much intact.
Wow, wow, wow. So those two cars going to the
They're
States?
They're going to the States, yes.
States? Okay, yeah.
And that car is going to remain as is.
Okay. Yeah.
Serviced, new drivetrain.
Make it drivable.
Running, driving. Mm-hmm. You'll see that at a meeting at some point.
Oh, wow,
in that condition, because again, most of them have been taken and restored and brought back. Mm-hmm. Very, very few original barn find Eastern Bloc cars left.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm the bus guy, but I've learned quite a bit about 40s Beetles.
You're doing good. You explained on the Beetles.
You know, I'm never too old to learn something new.
Awesome. Thank you, Jerry.
Oh,
thank
my
you.
Pleasure, Chef.
Thank you. Thank you.
What?
The gearbox.
Yeah, yeah.
Crush box, right?
Yeah, crush box. 25 horsepower, 16-inch wheel.
Yeah. Wow.
It's, so it's drinking 0.7 liters per 10 kilometers.
Oh,
so
wow.
Rather silly. It's the brake light for the
Oh, that's
the
brake light.
That's extra. Because the original is only this in the nose.
Oh, yeah.
Two lights.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, that's good.
Two red beans back there.
Okay. Oh, you're breaking. I painted the glass red.
Yeah. You have to do that because they are bleaching in the sun. Yeah. They are yellow in a few years.
Come here. Here we go.
And that this is my original car. So.
So you said you have since
1975.
75.
So 48 years this autumn. So I bought it for a sum of €200 back then. And I thought it was expensive.
Wow.
You know.
Wow. Well, that's good.
It's nice.
Yeah, very
or
cool.
Or he, because he's named Ferdinand.
Mm-hmm. Ferdinand, okay, Ferdinand.
I would like.
What? Can you tell what's happened?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I know just this. I can show you. It's a long story. I owned this car about 10 years.
You owned this car
10 years? When I bought it was a bare shell and a pan. So the only thing included when I bought it, it was this door. And the handbrake lever and the crotch cooler hatch on the other side.
Oh,
that
were
the only parts that I got when I bought it. But the history is, this was a forest wreck in Sweden.
In Sweden, okay.
Yeah. And there was a guy in Sweden who saved it, and then he sold the car off in parts.
Wow.
So we have a very well-known guy in Sweden.
So this is 51, 52?
It's very complicated. The floor pan is 1950.
Oh, 1950?
The body is 51.
51, yeah.
So I believe it might be an old rally car because you have holes for extra.
Oh, so then.
You have extra aerials and you have a lot of weird holes in the dashboard.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Yeah, and afterwards, I have been able to trace parts from this car.
Yeah,
I was able to buy this all the fenders from Gunnar Olsson.
Oh, wow.
Gunnar Olsson. And then I know that Gunnar, he sold the front lid and the rear lid from the car. But wow. You don't know where they are.
Wow.
So I'm still looking for the original front lid. Mm-hmm. But I was able to track the original rear lid down. So now I'm just looking for the original part at front that belongs to this car.
Yes, interior original?
No, everything was
missing.
This is actually from a 50s.
Yeah.
So I'm still searching for a decent set of shares because it's very hard to find.
Wow.
So, it has been many years just collecting the correct parts and get it complete.
Wow.
But I'm still searching for decent shares, and I would need a new door side because this one is really falling apart. And
wow. Good. Thank you.
Kommt zum Dienst, da kommen
My name is Traugott Grundmann. I'm the owner of this car here. This is a V30, built 1936. And it was supposed to be on the road to check whether this car is able to make a people's car. So they built 30 cars, and all cars had to be destroyed by order because they needed the metal by the time. And we were lucky, one chassis survived. And if you got a VW, if you got a chassis, you got a complete car. So this is chassis number 26. And so we built on number 26 a body on the original chassis. So at the end, it will be an original car.
Wow. How did you find the chassis?
The chassis was found in a wood in Austria. And one collector kept it. And I was able, 25 years ago, to trade a Schwimmwagen for the chassis. Yeah, I knew and my son, we knew, okay, this is a very, very rare piece, so it was worth doing it by the time. And then I completed the chassis, and first I thought, okay, I only do the chassis. But on the end, we decided, okay, we make a complete car. And in the meantime, we found original pieces like the door handles, the complete instrument panel. Yeah, the complete instrument panel is original. It took us 4 years on looking on the internet all over the world, finding the stuff. But now we got the complete original instrument panel and original steering wheel. So we try to get the car as original as possible.
How did you find out those measurements of
good? Yeah, we got lots of pictures by the time, and we were lucky. We got the head of design of Audi by the time, and he came to Hessisch-Oldendorf and made one-to-one drawings. And after the one-to-one drawings, they made a wooden model, and all this metal was hammered over the wooden metal, and that's what came out. Okay, we started with the metalwork 2 years ago. There's 2 years, it's 2 years of labor to get the car the way it is now.
Can I see the interior?
Sure, I open the door and take a look inside. So you see the original steering wheel and the original.
Those are original.
All original parts. From 1936.
So this is, what is the official name? So some people call it W30,
yes.
Some people say B430, some people say BW30. So what is the?
The original that is W30.
W30. Because they produce only 30 cars.
Yeah. Big.
And what kind of engine is it?
Okay, the engine. Yeah, the engine we still have to build. As you see, the wheels are not original, but you know, we are in the process of restoring the car and still looking all over the world to find parts as close as possible to the original.
So you plan to finish this car to make it?
We will finish the car for sure, but it takes time. Good things need time, you know.
So this car was a four-cylinder car or what?
It was a four-cylinder car, 900 cubic inches, 23 horsepower.
900
cubic inches. Yes, 9. Okay. Yeah.
So engines, so there's no window in the
part? No, it's no window in the part.
So you have to see through?
Yeah, if you look through the inside, you really can through, yeah. Through the vents. You can really look outside. I couldn't believe it, but it works.
Oh, it works?
It works, yeah. You can check it with your camera if you like. And if you look here, you can see through the vents. Yeah, this is a very nice shape, you know. Yeah. From the design, I think it's perfect, you know. Yeah. If you look, everything looks nice. Yeah. And for example, here these handles, you know, were made by myself, you know, out of aluminum, you know, because you won't find original ones, so I had to do it as close as possible to the original.
For the car dimension, it looks like a bigger than Beetle.
No, it's not bigger.
It's not bigger? Okay.
No, it's not bigger. We put it aside of the 38, and it's very close.
Oh, really?
It's very close, yeah.
Same wheelbase is the same?
No, it's not the same wheelbase. And if you look at the repro in the Autostadt, you will realize the shifting mechanism is far to the front. And ours is exactly the way it is, so it's different. Okay. Yeah, and the mount for the spare wheel is completely different. And the front suspension, yeah, normally it's straight. In this car, it's like this on an angle. So I had to redo the front beam. Yeah. Yeah, this
okay, is handmade.
Everything handmade, yes.
And what is it? This is a
this is a horn.
This is
a horn. Yeah. And it was again finding these glasses, you know, because these are the old Bosch glasses.
Oh, this original?
Original glasses, yeah. Yeah, we have to redo the rings. This was a little different, but you know, we're getting there step by step.
Oh, and one question. So how did you bring in the car here?
Yeah, we had to disassemble the car. We had to take away the fenders, and we had to take away the front axle in order to get it through the door. And then we have put it together here to show it.
Several times ago, so you guys...
Sure, yeah, yeah. No, but we managed, you know, was 1 centimeter on the right, 1 centimeter on the left side, so very carefully we put it in. And on Sunday we have a celebration in the church, you know, with the priest, you know, staying in front of this car, I think.
Wow.
That's something special. So you should be here on Sunday.
Yeah, yeah.
At 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock,
10 o'clock, yeah. Yeah.
Wow, this is first time for me.
control.
Nice. Hier ist der heimische Radwein.
Ich hab's verwirrt. Ich
Why waste time?
You need to put it in the film.
Leave that one. That's so bizarre. That jarenlang aan de weg zo te hebben
gekregen. The weather is absolutely manicuring now.
Thank you.
hier so alle.
Hey Peter, good to see you. How's it going?
Fine, how about you?
Good, good. Wow, you got more accessory parts?
I don't think so. I think it's the same.
Good to see you. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, all right. Okay, have fun.
All right, okay.
Thank you.
Until the big award ceremony for the Peter Max Müller Gedächtnisse Rennen, which is going to happen right here on the center stage of Hessisch Ohlendorf. And the Peter Max Müller Rennen award ceremony at 6 o'clock. Corona times, it's not allowed to hug an orange shirt, but do a fist pump with an orange shirt, you know, or give him a hug. So all those orange shirts, they deserve a big hug and a big applause for making this wonderful event happen. Everybody. So, and we are from all over the world, and we have many ways of getting to Hessisch Ohlendorf. And one way of getting to Hessisch Ohlendorf is to participate in the Peter Max Müller Gedächtnis Rennen, which is organized by enthusiasts for enthusiasts. And it's about old race cars with Volkswagen heritage. And Volkswagen and racing did not always go together. It was a people's car. But of course somebody races it. And one of our heroes, Peter Max Müller, was one of the early pioneers of building race cars based on Volkswagens. And this hobby is very much alive today. And in front of us here is a typical example of a car built by the owner for himself based on his own passion and own need for speed and competition. All based on parts and cars from before 1960, period correct with Porsche parts or Porsche engine parts, Porsche brake parts. And it's a way of sort of very global participation. We all met up in Wolfsburg, went over to the cradle of Peter Max Müller to visit his home, and then we raced through the mountains here, long, hard drives at night time and in the morning, and then checkpoints that have to be checked in order to get here to the finish line in Hessisch Ohlendorf. So we are very grateful to have the finish line here, and are very grateful for the support of the whole HO team and the Grumman family here. And we will look at the results. Because every year the Peter Max Müller Rennen is limited to 25 entries, and they sort in three classes. It's completely stock, completely original 1200 engine. There's a Okrasa class with dual carburetors, and there's an unlimited class where you can have the bigger engines, but all based on pre-1960 tuning equipment. So, the jury has counted the checkpoints. The jury has investigated the pictures, the proof that it all happened. And I now have the results of the International Peter Max Müller jury. Are you ready for the results? Okay, we start with the stock class. Standard 25 or 30 horsepower engines. The average time this year was in the order of 1.5 hours in the intensive part of the racing. The third place finishers of the stock class used over 4 hours. And they are in front of us right here, Roland Stoffelen and his son, Floris Stoffelen. Third place. And the reason, of course, is that the clutch cable broke right on the autobahn. But a Peter Max Müller racer doesn't stop. He gets out, changes the clutch cable, puts it back in, and races into Hesse Zollendorf. So Floris, the son, congratulations. Thank you. Well, are you a better navigator or a better clutch cable changer?
Both, I think. The clutch cable was a really difficult job because we had to change the nuts. We didn't have a good one. But for navigation, I think we had made it under an hour. But it was 4 hours, so perfect.
But they finished, and they finished strong. Roland Stoffelen from the Netherlands and Torres. Second place in the stock class. With 1 hour 28 minutes and 55 seconds from Germany in the 1953 Oval, Diana Rocher and her navigator Sonja Angermeyer. Congratulations, Diana. You broke your car after the race. Have you fixed it?
Yes, it's fixed on the front line dealer here, and it runs and stands over there at the oval.
Fantastic, fantastic. You did a great job. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Then we have a winner in the stock class. 1 hour, 18 minutes, 55 seconds. Beat by 10 minutes. 1951 Wieger Coupe from Norway, driven by Sivert Aspiel and his navigator Lucas Eriksson. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Was it the driving or the navigating?
Both.
Any dangerous situations along the road?
Always, it's a race.
All right, so this is the winners of the stock class. Give them a big hand. Fantastic. We say thank you, and we go to the Oprasa class. And in the unlimited class, you have to collect more checkpoints than in the stock class. Stock class goes slow, has to select a few checkpoints, but the unlimited class has to select 12 checkpoints. You have to select on a map where to go and be smart in selecting, be smart in navigating, and be smart in driving. So mastering these three crafts is very important. The unlimited class had many entrants. It was a very hard competition with only 20 minutes separating first to fourth. Third place, first up on the podium here, a legendary team from Germany, number 294, driven by Traugott Grundmann and the Burgermeister, Tarik Renesi. Third place, the Burgermeister of Hesse Zollendorf. Who can know the back roads better? <Woo-hoo>! Congratulations, guys! Very good! Congratulations, Tarik! Fantastic effort! So, Traugott, was it the driving or was it the navigating?
It was the navigator, for sure.
For sure!
very hard for you. But I mean, you are the Bürgermeister. You know every road out here, so it's going to be easy for you.
Yes, very easy.
That is very big. I think it is important. So, but, while you're up here, Bürgermeister, thank you so much for opening up your city for this wonderful arrangement.
I would like to thank all of the volunteers here. And, and of course, special thanks go to the Grundmann family, without whom this event would not be possible.
Not at all.
Tarek just said I'm very, very happy and I'm surprised. That's why I'm at a loss of words.
But gaining third place in Unlimited class demands a great team. It's not a solo job, so it's both the Bürgermeister and Tarek. Congratulations, Tarek.
Thank you.
All right. Unlimited class, just 8 minutes faster with the time 1:46:10 from Switzerland. 1957, Carmen Gia, Gerhard Gysi, and Philipp Hauptlin. Gerhard, congratulations! Congratulations! All right, Swiss precision. What is your winning recipe?
Yeah, it was the team. Navigation from Philipp, I'm a driving, and yeah, experience.
Did you enjoy the race?
Yeah, it was great. Thanks for organization, and it was really great experience.
Thank you very much for coming. I mean, it's all about this global family coming from all over the world, you know, to represent here at Hessenholm. Thank you very much. All right. Dogs, number one, numero uno, winning with a total of 14 minutes in the unlimited class. These are the fastest, fiercest. From Germany, in a 56 oval, race team number 13, Moritz B. and Alex Meyer. Moritz B. and Alex Meyer, there you go. Congratulations, Moritz. Fantastic. Congratulations, Alex. Really good. So, the car held up, no problems?
No, first time that the car was really great. And the last two races, we had a bit of not so lucky in terms of techniques. So this time, first time that everything worked perfectly fine. And so that's why it was very much an easy job.
Easy job, all right. Now, your tactics, was it to go for many point checkpoints worth 1 point, or go for the big value checkpoints?
So basically more for the big value checkpoints, and then see how we can do the shortest cuts in between, and that was our recipe, as I said.
Fantastic. Now, do you guys stay friends throughout the race, or is it a lot of arguing? All right, excellent. And I heard, Moritz, somebody whispered to me, there's your birthday today.
Oh yes, unfortunately it is.
Happy birthday! Hi, Moritz!
Happy birthday to you!
Fantastic! One last picture here of the top three of the Unlimited class. Fundamental first tuning kit to the Volkswagen, the dual carburetors, and we're laying the foundation for a tuned Volkswagen to be driven on the street during the weekend or participating in a race during the weekend for daily driving. And we need to comment that the Petermax race is only possible by effort by great enthusiasts that contribute, come with great tips on doing the sightseeing, on doing setting up the racing, and of course our sponsors, Just Campers and the Cool Flow crew for making the clothing, the Grundmann family and the Think Tank Design Company from the UK. Big hand. All right, Oprasa class, we are ready with the time 1:35.57, just 7 minutes separating the best from the fourth. Third place, Oprasa class, race team number 55 from Germany in a 55-0, Stefan Busio and his son Max Busio. Stefan and Max. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Father and son, no arguments in the car, or do you agree?
No arguments. No good.
All good, no arguments, that's the way it is. You have driven the Petromax before in a faster car, this one in a Volkswagen. What's your tactic in doing well?
No tactics at all.
Full throttle.
Yeah. Throttle, and like a friend of mine said, in the Volvo, don't break. Give everything, it's all this time.
Don't use the brakes, there you go. All right, with only 3 minutes ahead of you, second place in the Oprasa class, race car number 153 from Germany, Thomas Schuster and Markus Zoll in the Haset Oval. Congratulations, Thomas.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So Thomas, your wonderful oval with the three headlamps in the front. It was sort of a debut race for your long race. Did it work as expected?
Yeah, it worked very well. We had no problems with the engine all the last time. And yeah, it was a big pleasure to drive with you. It was a big experience for us.
Do you feel the competition when you're on the starting line running towards, you know, is the adrenaline at the top?
Very high adrenaline.
But you drove safe and compliant with all the rules at all times.
Yes.
Of course, very good. All right. The winner of the biggest class of them all, the fiercest competition, with only 3 minutes margin to Thomas, with a time 1:29.03. From Switzerland, in a Hemmeler, Roman Hunter and Roger Stettler. The Swiss guy is kicking it off here in classes. Fantastic. Congratulations, Roman.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Peter.
Thank you.
Fantastic, all the way from Switzerland. You bought all these super nice cars, went all the way to Wolfsburg and raced with us. What is it about Volkswagens that is so good for them?
Yeah, we work with Volkswagen, so it's our life.
It's our life. That's a good thing. It's for all of us. This is the best part of our life, isn't it? Being here in Sizongo. Fantastic. The Hemmeler that you drove, it held up well? No problems with the car or anything?
No, this year.
I remember you had some problems. What was your tactic here in selecting the checkpoints? What were your sort of tactic?
We took more 1 points.
Alright, more 1 points. Because checkpoints are worth anything from 1 to 3 points. Congratulations. Thanks for coming all the way. Big hand for the unlimited class. Oh, sorry, across the class. Come forward. Come forward and come together. There you go.
There are three ladies from the Ukraine. And yeah, we are so proud that they are here despite all of the really, really horrible circumstances. But they are here, we are so happy to have you here because they are happy too, because in their motherland it is actually not possible to perform in front of a stage, perform in front of an audience, but here at Hettisch-Ohlendorf it's possible. Welcome, please come on stage, the ladies trio from the Ukraine!
Do 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 do
Hey, how are you?
Yeah, good.
Nice. Thank you for mercy, yeah, yeah. I want you with me, yeah.
Finally. Wow, that's difficult to drive,
that's
I think.
Difficult to drive, yeah. Ich hab alle. Ja?